This motion graphics video is the perfect example of how some simple effects can really improve a basic animation and help to sell it as more interesting than what actually is. In this video, I want to recreate some of this composition and share with you some simple effect combination that we can add to any animation to create that extra layer of care and attention. This video is sponsored by Silwizard Frame by Frame Animation Library, but more about that after the tutorial. The first effect is the form at impact. I have a normal bouncing ball, but it's not really convincing, it's a little bit stiff. I could improve it with some squash and stretch, but sometimes squash and stretch can be a little bit too cartoony. So here's an alternative that we can try. Create an adjustment layer and position it above the element that is going to be deformed by the impact. Apply the effect Liquify and select the brush tool. Adjust the brush dimension and then you can distort your layer. Then add a keyframe to the distortion percentage and set it at 100 at the moment of the impact. Set it to 0 on the frame before. And 0 again after more or less half a second after the impact. Okay, now I want to smooth the curve a little bit and I'm copying this keyframe for every bounce where I've put the keyframe in red. Since the sphere loses kinetic energy at every bounce, we have to lower the percentage of the distortion. I'm setting the second bounce at 70 instead of 100. And the third bounce only at 20. Reactive light and shadow. This is a very popular one, maybe because it's really cool but also really easy to make. I have this composition with my sphere that moves around this grid of panels. The only animation at the moment are just few position keyframes on the sphere that moves between the panel, and I also animated the position of the panels to make some room when the sphere passes through. The first thing to do is to duplicate the composition where you have all of your environments and apply the effect radial fast blur. You have to select the center of the effect and position it on the sphere. Then select the center position property pickwhip and parent it to the position of the sphere. Now the center of the radial fast blur will follow the position of the sphere. I want to increase the amount of radial blur a little bit, let's say 90, and I also want to have it in a uniform color, so I'm applying a fill effect to make it blue. We are done with the shadow, now we need some dynamic light, so we can duplicate our environment layer and apply a brightness effect on it. Then we create a new solid layer and use a mask to create a faded circle. And we will use this circle as a matte for the brighter environment composition. Then, if we parent our faded circle to the sphere, the matte will follow the sphere position. And that's it. Now we have a light and shadow system that follows your elements and creates a really cool interaction with the graphics around it. Last effect is revealing lenses. First thing, I recreated a similar comp to my video reference, but you can obviously use it in any type of context. I have some concentric circles, one with 4 gradient effects, another circle, some graphics, and an adjustment layer with a blur effect, a brightness effect, and some mask. I have the usual blue sphere that rotates inside the circle and scale to the center. And lastly, parented to the sphere, I have a comp with an animation of floating objects that will be the hidden layer that inside of the sphere. Now we have to set up our lenses to reveal the hidden layer. First of all, we create a new adjustment layer and we apply a Gaussian blur effect on it. We create a circular mask and increase the blur effect, and we already can start to see that this is already the right direction. In my case, I want to create a new round shape layer because I want a stroke around my lens, so I am parenting this round shape layer to my adjustment layer, but you can skip this part depending on the aesthetics of your project. Then we need to create a second circle for the second lens, and we need to have this new circle cancel out the blur of the first one. Like if by aligning this second lens, it creates a focus and removes the blurriness of the first lens. So we select the first circle and set the new one as a matte. After that, we click on this icon to invert the matte so that the blur of the first lens is now outside the second lens. Okay, perfect. Now we have a second circle that works as a revealer, and where it moves, it cancels the blur effect. Now it's time to play a little bit with the position of our lenses. So in this case, I'm moving the lens position to the side. I want to apply the same position animation also to the first lens and add some ease to smooth the movement. Along with the position, I also want to animate the dimension of our lenses so that they scale up while moving towards the center. I also need to animate the stroke thickness to keep it consistent during the scale, but that's only because I choose to add that stroke to frame my lenses, and you can totally avoid that. So, okay, we have animated the position and scale of the lenses going into the scene. Now we can just copy the keyframe to make them going out. I also want to add some rotation around the center, so I'm going to add a null object that will be the center of the rotation. Then we can parent our lenses to this null object, and if we keyframe the null rotation, giving him a couple of rounds, the lenses will follow. To create a more dynamic scene, we can also set some offset between the scale and the position of the two lenses. We just need to select all the keyframes from the first layer and move them slightly along the timeline. I would say something around just 5 or 10 frames. I want to separate a little bit the two layers, so I'm adding a drop shadow effect and setting it very, very light. Here you go, 3 cool effects that you can try next time a client asks you for some wow effect. And also, this video was sponsored by cellwizard.com. It's a library of editable elements for After Effects, but the really cool thing is that all these elements are not the usual flat, boring motion graphic icons, but are animated frame by frame so that they can rotate on themselves, they morph, and they are way more organic than other motion graphics presets. They are modular, so that they can be combined to create different animation sequences, and they are also fully editable, so that you can have them match your aesthetic and your visual style. If you are a little bit curious, check it out at cellwizard.com, there is a link in the description. Also, subscribe for the next tutorial, and if there is something about animation or motion graphic that you would like to see, please let me know in the comments. Bye!